Betty Hoskins decided to sell this ring online. A buyer agreed to buy it for $4,000, but when the check came, it was for $4,500. Hoskins agreed to send the extra $500 back with the ring, but the more she looked at the check, the more she grew suspicious.
Something in my gut told me not to trust it, so I didn't trust it.
She called a 1-800 number on the check and spoke to a customer service representative.
And then she finally said, "I really can't tell you anything. All I can tell you is that this time that check won't cash."
Never accept an overpayment from anyone if you're selling something online.
Tej Shramushnam from the Federal Trade Commission says Americans lose millions every year in fake check scams, including this one, known as an overpayment scam. Here's how it works. A con artist sends a check for more than the agreed price and asks the recipient to deposit it and send the difference back. A few days later, the bank realizes the check is a fake, and now the victim has a bad check and is out $500.
Be very wary of sending wires to people that you don't know. The minute the money leaves your account, there's just very little recourse for people.
Betty kept getting texts from the person who sent the check. When she wrote back that it was a scam, she didn't hear from them again. Katherine Johnson, CBS News, New York.